Stormy, I love you, wife. I love you, Dave. I love you. Thank y'all.
Celebrities try to keep it cool when they're out. They try as much as possible to avoid getting into a fight with anyone. But come on, they're humans too. Sometimes things get out of hand. Especially in the hip-hop industry, things can go from beef to diss, shooting, stabbing, or fighting. Let's talk about some rappers that got into a fight. Before we start the video, make sure to leave a like, and if you would like to join this month's giveaway of one of these items on the screen, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video to the end to comment the hidden keyword. Good luck! G-Herbo and Lil Bibby. Both rappers go way back. G-Herbo and Lil Bibby gained their first attention with the song Kill Shit, which gained over 42 million views on YouTube. They gained broader attention within the hip-hop community when Drake called them the future. G-Herbo and Lil Bibby had a show at Toad's Place in New Haven, Connecticut. After the concert, an unknown man allegedly tried to snatch Bibby's chain, which resulted in a fight. It's difficult to tell what happened exactly from the footage, but it appears that Bibby hands his chain to a friend at the beginning of the clip, only for the brawl to begin a few seconds later. What happened? Was someone trying to jack the free crack MC? It's clear that tensions were high and at least a few people were probably injured in the altercation. People started to fight one another, including Bibby and G-Herbo. According to a guard at Toad's Place, the incident initially began when security wouldn't allow the younger brother of Bibby's security guard in VIP earlier in the night. The NLMB member mushed one of the bouncers in the head and was body slammed. The NLB member later alerted G-Herbo, Lil Bibby, and others. This resulted in NLMB members attacking the bouncers and probably others who didn't know the root of the problem attacking one another. 40 Glock. Lawrence Carl Demetorius White, better known as 40 Glock, is an American rapper from Compton, California. Glock negotiated a deal with Empire Music Works and distribution by BMG. Through the deal, he got a record and released his first solo effort, The Jackal, which featured guests such as Badass, Razzcas, Corrupt, Mac Minister, and several others. After the album, he parted with Empire Music Works. 40 Glock has worked with artists such as Dr. Dre, The Alchemist, and Havoc, among others. Glock was involved in altercations with fellow rap artists. In 2012, he was involved in a fight with Jayceon Taylor, popularly known as The Game, and his friends outside a mansion in Hollywood. He sued The Game for $4.5 million in damages for assault and battery, as well as damage to his reputation. Game never seemed worried about the charges. Instead, he saw it as helping Glock out by dishing his beatings. He said because 40 Glock was bullying rappers, referring to the past altercations Glock had with the likes of Lil Wayne, Plies, and Jamie Foxx, he had to beat him. Game believes that since he's beaten Glock, he has changed for good because he did more inspirational tweets. He also got into a physical fight with Menace during the Cage and Khan's event at the LA Sports Arena in Los Angeles. The fight had allegedly stemmed from G-Unit and Black Wall Street having a long-lasting dispute. NBA Youngboy. NBA Youngboy got into a fight during a concert in South Carolina after a particularly grabby fan tried to snatch his chain. In a video released by TMZ, NBA is seen riding on the shoulders of a security guard in the middle of the crowd. Someone reaches up to snatch his chain from behind, yanking the rapper backward. And when he goes to take the chain off, another attempt is made to gank the jewelry. That was enough for Youngboy to start throwing punches. The chain snatcher kept trying his luck, though, till Youngboy went back to the stage and started rapping alongside Quando. The failed chain snatch started heckling from the floor. Quando stopped the music and dared the big talker to speak up. As soon as he did, Youngboy jumped into the crowd and started swinging. This wasn't the first time that Youngboy has been in a fight with an audience member on his tour. He also threw fists with a fan during a Richmond show, although the cause of that scuffle was less obvious. 50's Crew and Gunplay. Curtis James Jackson III, known professionally as 50 Cent, is an American rapper and songwriter known for his impact in the hip-hop industry. He's been described as a master of the nuanced art of lyrical brevity. 50 Cent released the compilation album Guess Who's Back, and through the album, he was discovered by Eminem and signed to Shady Records under the aegis of Dr. Dre's Aftermath Entertainment and Interscope Records. With the aid of Eminem and Dr. Dre, who produced his first major label album Get Rich or Die Trying, 50 Cent became one of the world's best-selling rappers and rose to prominence as the de facto leader of East Coast hip-hop group G-Unit. About Gunplay. Richard Morales Jr., known as Gunplay, is an American rapper from Carroll City, Florida. Gunplay started his career in hip-hop as a member of fellow Florida-based rapper Rick Ross's southern hip-hop group, Triple C's. 50's G-Unit was seen in a fight with Gunplay in the footage. 50 Cent, Tony Yayo, Mike Knox, and other members of G-Unit can be seen walking past some trailers backstage in an award show in Atlanta. Everything was calm until the crew butts heads with Maybach Music's Gunplay, whom they began to attack. The footage is shaky and unclear, so it's difficult to tell who is who in the footage, but Gunplay is being beaten by some men before he can get up and retaliate. During an interview with G-Unit affiliate Mike Knox, he gave his account of the story and maintained that though 50 Cent was around the area, he wasn't involved in the fray. In the released video, it's unclear whether 50 threw a punch or not though. Gunplay didn't say anything about 50 throwing punches at him either. Instead, he said it was the rapper's bodyguards who attacked him. He said in an interview, "I stood up in the paint like a real G supposed to with 5 bodyguards that's trained to kill a man. If you think that was crazy, check out this story." Mobb Deep and Saigon. Mobb Deep was an American hip-hop duo from Queensbridge, Queens, New York. The duo consisted of rappers Havoc and Prodigy. They're considered to be among the main progenitors of hardcore East Coast hip-hop and hip-hop in the mid-1990s. Mobb Deep became one of the most successful rap duos in history, having sold over 3 million records. They were known for their albums The Infamous, Hell on Earth, and Murder Music. Their top hits include Shook Ones, Part 2, Survival of the Fittest, and Hell on Earth, Front Lines. Saigon, on the other hand, named Brian Daniel Kernard, better known by his stage name Saigon, is an American rapper. After years of delay due to former record label interference, his album The Greatest Story Never Told was released on Suburban Noise Records. He's also known for his appearances on the HBO television series Entourage. Saigon and Mobb Deep were in a fight at SOB's in New York City during a Havoc show. According to the footage released, Saigon and his crew can be seen arguing on stage with Mobb Deep and their entourage, followed by a scuffle in which Saigon is seen punching Prodigy in the face before being chased out of the venue by the mob's crew. According to Prodigy, Saigon was not expected to perform at Havoc's show, but the DJ announced that there was going to be a special guest performance by Saigon, which made some of Mobb's crew uncomfortable. That was how the argument started on stage. Saigon later fled the scene when he was outnumbered by the crew, according to him. He said, "I had already rocked Prodigy, it was time to dip up out of there." Havoc also took turns to mock Saigon fleeing the club. "How do you jump on another man's back? How do you do that? He jumped on another man's back to flee the club. He started with us from the beginning. He's a whack new rapper who will never be a legend. Mobb Deep are legends. If you think I'm wrong, say I'm wrong, but I got mad gold and platinum plaques." The beef allegedly stemmed from an interview Prodigy did, where he mentioned that he didn't like Saigon. Sai responded later by saying he would get Prodigy, and he eventually did. "Hey you, yeah you, you like the video? Great, we got another one for you that we guarantee you'll like. And all you have to do is click on the screen. It's free and without any hidden fees, but you have to click on fast because this message will self-destruct in 5 seconds.